Let's talk about gravitational potential energy. This is commonly denoted by the symbol U, and of course it's measured in your joules. Now, if we know the potential at a point, let's say phi, you know phi at this point, then it follows that the potential energy, or the gravitational potential energy of a mass M that I place at that point, will have a potential energy U that equals to M multiplied by phi. And that is the simple concept of gravitational potential energy. So I need to know phi. If I put a mass there, its GPE will be M times phi. And so it follows that also the formula of gravitational potential energy can be written as minus G M M over R. Okay, and so if I have some other big mass M over here, and I'm looking at a point, a distance R from this, the center of this mass, then you can see that this expression here is simply phi. Oh, I should include the minus sign. Yeah. Okay, this expression here is phi, and so I multiply by M, and I get the GPE of M at a point. So, very simple. And so what we want to do over here now, okay, we want to discuss the concept of equipotential lines. This is a very nice concept, okay? So, fields have field lines. Well, potential have equipotential lines. And so, if you think about it, if I have a mass M over here, an equipotential line is simply all the points in space that have the same potential. And so, for an isolated mass, those would describe concentric circles around this mass. And so I'm just going to draw a couple of these equipotential lines, okay? And so it could be the case where the potential here on this line could be minus 100 joules per kg. Potential here on this line could be, let's say, I don't know, minus 80 joules per kg, for example. Okay, and so every point on this line has a potential of 80 joules per kg. Okay, and every point on this line has a potential of minus 100 joules per kilogram. And so, if I have a mass, let's say over here, M, that moves through some complicated path but ends up here, what I can say for sure is that the change in potential of this mass is simply phi final minus phi initial, okay? And in that case, that will be minus 100 minus minus 80, and that gives me a loss in potential of minus 20 joules per kilogram. And so if I want to find this change in GPE, then that's just M delta phi, okay, which will be the mass of this object times minus 20. Okay, the minus sign here simply indicates that it is that the mass had lost some GPE. And so by conservation of energy, I can deduce that it would gain some KE. And this is essentially what we need to understand about GPE, right? How we use it, okay, and how we can use it to calculate the changes in energy of a mass that travels around in space.